Good morning, everyone. Today we'll begin with the second module, that is storage and networking technologies and virtualization. So this is the second module of the storage area networks, and today we'll be discussing about the first chapter. The first chapter, it consists of total four chapters. So today we'll be discussing the first chapter. And the first chapter name is Fiber Channel Storage Area Networks. Okay, so before I begin into the, as you know that organizations are, experiencing a lot of data in, there is an increase in the data. It can be any organization, I can take it. Even if it is a smaller organization also, there the data is increasing day by day. A very startup company, from there even you start, as and days pass on, there is a huge data. And when we are talking about this data or this information, when I say that, the main concept comes that how do I store that information, how it is to be protected, it is to be optimized, and it has to be managed efficiently. Please remember the major concept when we have been saying in terms of the coding, development, or the analyst and all. Whenever this all has to come, the system analyst is going to work on this data, what they have been having. Because the storage of the information is very important, and how they are going to put in front of the people. Having lot of data, how do you put it in a very systematic manner in front of the people is very much important, and how do you store and how do you retrieve that data. So this is a tedious task of the data centers manager, because their main challenge is to provide the data at the low cost and also at the high performance. So they are really working on this one so that their investment is very much less, but the performance what I'm been requiring is very much high. I can say that I invest less money, but I want the greater result in the business. So for that, you really need to apply a lot of logic how we can do that one. So he tells that whenever we are looking for this information management solution, what else is being required? So what, why are we looking, the focus is into this one. The first one is just in-time information to the business users. As I've already stated that people are impatient. They are not having a patience to hold back even 1 minute, even if it is processing, they don't have that much patience. So as and when I request for the data, it has to be available. So this is the very much important for an information manager to make sure that anytime the data is being asked, it has to be available for 24/7. Okay, then the second one is integration of the information infrastructure with the business processes. You have to make sure that there is a change in that information, then the security and the integrity of the information should not be compromised. As and when, because the infrastructure keeps on changing, because day by day a new technology comes, new applications have been developed. At that particular point, the data should not be lost. And the second one is a flexible and resilient storage infrastructure. Here he tells here is the storage should be aligning with the current technologies. It is not that the technology is outdated, so the information is getting corrupted. That is not the case. For example, I'll say you is you have seen a CD, the tape recorders where that songs used to be stored on that magnetic tape, the tape, and if you, in case you rub that one, the information would be lost. If you take into that one, the usually the songs or the films were been recorded in that way. Now as a technology is been changing, we are all storing it in terms of the MP4. Now we can't say that the old songs, whatever they've been there, it cannot be transformed. So now here there is a change in that infrastructure. The storage infrastructure is being changed, where we are moving from those cassettes to the CDs. Okay, now we are moving it to the digital online music systems and all. So this all, whenever there is a change, that information should not be vanished away. If we lose that information, then no use of the upgraded technologies. So for this purpose, how can we use this one? So as you people know that when there was an evolution of these computers and all, we had the a disk attached to our computer, that they call it as a direct attached storage. Okay, so there means we had a particular disk attached to that one, and all the data used to be stored in that one. Now when we have been having the disk, it is presuming, it has been presumed by the user that that particular disk is only meant for him. Okay, and when he had to share and all, it was very difficult task, because more number of the devices have to be shared, then there was a problem that how it has to be shared between the various users. So for that purpose, they came across the term called as the storage area network, where it is a high speed dedicated network of the servers and shared storage devices. This is a pool, I can say, where you are sharing the servers also and you are sharing the devices also. Now when I'm using this one, why this storage area came into the existence and what is the benefit of that one, means we are going to have a centralized storage management. It is going to enable the storage resource to be shared across the multiple servers, and also it is increasing the storage demands where you can efficiently store, and also it is providing you the more scalability. It is not saying that okay, only 10 people can store the information, remaining it cannot be extended, nothing as such. You can increase the number of the servers, you can increase the number of the storage devices, and when they are been having this storage area network came into the existence, they had the there were the two types of the deployments. One is through the fiber channel, which they call it as FC-SAN, and the second one was the IP-SAN. And that means whenever there is a exchange of the data, then what is that link they are using to exchange the data from the devices to the host? Okay, so the one is the fiber channel. Hope everyone knows the fiber channel, which is having the higher greatest speed, which has been replaced by the various cables. Hope if you remember, we used to use the copper cables, we had the twisted pair cables, we had the coaxial cables, and later then we came across the fiber channels. So this fiber channel is used to connect to the storage area networks, and from there the data is being exchanged. And the second one is the IP-SAN, that means internet based protocols we are using, and we are exchanging the data from the storage devices to the host. Okay, so moving on, the next one is a fiber channel. So what is this fiber channel? He tells us it's a high speed network technology that runs on the high speed optical fiber cables and serial copper cables. Remember, this is also including the copper cables. The copper is not completely vanished, it is having, but the speed is at the very high speed. The speed, I can say, in terms of the gigabits, it has been going on. And why this fiber channel came into the why it was being invented is only to increase the speed, okay, and also make sure that the data loss, what was been going on, it has to be reduced. Using the coaxial cables or the copper cables, the cables were getting heated up, and because of which there was a loss of the data. So they used to use these amplifiers, right, in between the bridges and the switches they used to use, so that the data can be regained. Now, and as the data, as I said that the data has to be transmitted at a very faster rate. So this was the boon for the networking technology. And I can say that this architecture, that is especially fiber cable architecture, is highly scalable. Highly scalable in the sense I can connect it to the n number of the devices, and the performance is going to remain the same. It is giving, like if it is giving you 1 Gbps data transfer, then it is going to make sure that it is going to give the same bandwidth for each and every user. It is not going to degrade the performance. For that purpose, this fiber cable came into the existence. The next one, we are looking into the storage area networks and its evolution. How exactly this storage area came into the picture and how it has been evolving day by day. So as I already stated, storage area network is carrying the data between the servers and the storage devices. So you can see that in this figure, where you can see that here we have the host, and these are the clients, or the host I can say, and you are having the IP network to share the data. These are your application server. Different application server are being there, and you can see that you are using the VMware hypervisor to share the multiple operating system. Now you can see here they are using the fiber cable, that is fiber channel, a storage area network. Now you can see that these are the storage arrays. You can have multiple storage arrays. Please remember, I can have here also one more array, then I can have here another array, and I can take up another array here also. So these are the storage arrays, and these are being connected to this fiber channel with the help of the fiber channel, and the data is being transferred using this fiber channel to these application servers. From these application servers, with the help of the IP network, they are transferring the information. Okay, so please remember these terms, because now whenever we are transferring, as I said in the previous class also, that we used to have just one client, okay, and then we had for this particular the server. And now I can't make for every, now in case I have multiple hosts and they are requesting for this server itself. So based on the time, the throughput is going to decrease, because it has to make sure it is going to satisfy each and every user. So this is only one server having attached to one particular database, right? Now when the demand is increasing, then automatically the performance is going to go down. So it has to be avoided. You have to make sure all the users are going to get the same performance. For that purpose, we are using a different application servers. When we are having these application servers, each application server is being connected to one particular storage area, right? Storage array or anything. Now if it is been there, again this application server is being loaded as it is being connected. Please remember, how do I retrieve the data at a very faster rate is important. That means which is the cable in between for which, through which we can get this data. That is the main task of the storage areas network. The data will be stored, that is not a problem, but the retrieval at the faster rate to fetch that information and get back to the user is very much important. And at that same time, the write operation is also important. Please remember that read and write, both operations are important. So this is how they have been using the fiber channel for the purpose of the transfer of the data. Now, initially when they had this one, they had a doubt that for this particular fiber cable to get connected, which device can we use that one? So what they used is, initially they had this hub. Okay, hope everyone knows what the functionality of a hub. But the problem what when they had this hub, that configuration was being called as fiber channel arbitrated loop. Okay, that was being named as a FC hub with the AC loop. Okay, FC AL loop it was being called. But as that hub had was not giving the performance as it was being expected by the people, so for that purpose they shifted to the switches. So now in between, that means here what I'm been talking here, this SAN area network, whatever is been there, as it is been connected to n number of the storage devices, so what they are using is, they are using this switches to get connected. Okay, so here the application server having n number of the application server, they are using this switches, and then the data will be transferred from any application server to the particular storage area, or from any storage area the data will be requested. So if I have to redraw this one, this is the switch having the number of the ports in this one. I can get connected to at this side the servers. Okay, so and at this side I can have the number of the storage area. So that is the areas I can having, or the arrays, whatever I'm having, I can get connected, and this is going to be the switch. So what happened here after using the switch? Remember, they used first hub, but the performance was very bad, so they shifted to this switch. So when they used this switch, so the data connectivity was very good, and also the performance, and also it was being scalable, because you might have seen the switch that is 24 port switch, or you are been having more number of the ports in that one, where you can get connected to the more number of the storage arrays. Okay, so with this one, the evolution of the storage area network took place. Now, when I'm been talking about this fiber channel storage area network, now let us see what are its components. When I'm been talking about the components, there are mainly four components. The first one is the nodes, or I can say that is the ports, node ports, that is especially with the server and the storage, both the sides it is going to come. So please remember. The second one is the cables and the connectors. Cable and connectors are two different things. The cable is something like a wire, and the connector is the point through which you are trying to connect the system with the cable. So you need a device that is going to act as an interface. And the next one is interconnecting devices such as switches and hubs. So I need a device that is going to connect the servers and the storage array. So that is either I am going to use the switch or the hub, and let us see that what are the benefits of using the switch, what are the benefits of using the hub. And lastly, the storage area network management software. Okay, everyone knows that whenever I am been saying a system, there is a combination of a hardware and the software. So to run even this particular devices, there is a software how I have to manage that one. So you need to either upgrade that software, or you have to update that one, or you have to reinstall and again reboot that one. So how, whenever the devices are not working properly, the performance goes less, then what action has to be performed? So that one we are going to see. So the next one is the first one is a node ports. So as you can see here, there is a device. So that is, I can say a particular host, I can say a server, or I can say a storage array, whatever you want to take it. Okay, now you can check this node is having the ports. So it is port 0, port 1, so many ports. As I said, a port is the a entry point or an exit point where through which the data will be transferred. Very simple answer. Now you can check that when I take this particular port, when I extend that one, it is showing a link through which I am going to connect it. Now when I'm having this connection, I can say that it is used to communicate, or it is used to transfer the data. Now when I'm having this one link, you can see there is something called as a TX and the RX. TX is nothing but transmit, and RX is nothing but receive. So each port, whenever I'm been saying, it is having the two links. One is to receive and another one is to send. I send the data and I receive the data, both at the same time. And now when I'm been sending this data and I'm receiving this data, please remember it is a full duplex communication it is been performing. If you remember the ways it is been communicating, one will be simplex, another one will be half duplex, and the third one will be full duplex. Simplex in the sense it is just one way. If you people remember the networks, so I shall draw it. Here I have a system and I'm transferring the data in one way. Just it is one way. It is just going to listen the orders and it is not giving any other information. So I am going to just send the information. So like a printer, right? From a computer to the printer, it is a one-way communication. I don't get anything back from the printer to the computer, any information. Okay? Except the papers are, the tray is empty. Other than that one, its work is only to print. No other information is coming back from the printer to the computer stating that don't give me any printing job and all. Okay, so that's a simplex. Now the second one is, hope if you remember, it is half a duplex. That means one person communicates until and the another person listens. When the second person is communicating, the first person is going to listen. Okay, as I can say that it is your walkie-talkie. You might have seen the police people having a walkie-talkie. First one person will communicate and then that information is reached to the another person, and then the second person is going to talk. So that is not been possible. And now here they are using the full duplex, where the transfer and the receiving is going simultaneously. That means it is going in parallel. It is not that the another person is the another device is waiting until and unless it is going to complete its task, and nothing as such. Okay, and you can see here they are having the adapters, the front end adapters, the back end adapters, whatever is being needed. Each and every node is going to maintain all those things, right? So you can use either host or the storage arrays or the tape libraries, all are acting as your nodes. So please remember this one. Okay, the next one is the second component what we have been having is cables and the connectors. As I said, cables, it's a wire that is being used to connect two devices. Okay, it is just as a medium, I can say, for the communication. Now, as I said, it is using the fiber channel. Then what are its components is, one is the copper cable it is having, and the another one is fiber cables. Copper cables, when I say, please remember, copper cables will get heated up, right? And because of that, we are using it only for the shorter distance. If you remember, we used to have cable connections. In between that one, it we used to have one thick copper, a wire in between. It's used only for a shorter distances. And the second one is the optical cables. Now you can see that everywhere they are digging and putting these optical cables, because it is used for to transfer the data for a longer distance. And when I'm saying this, SAN is implemented using optical cables. There are two types. One is the single mode, and the second one is the multi-mode. We are having single mode and the multi-mode. In single mode, you can check in this one. There is a, when I say optical cable, that means the data is being transferred in terms of the ray. Light has been there in, and it is being transferred. Now you can see that there is only one input being fed, and it is being used, for up to the distance of 10 kilometer. Okay, one single beam, you can see that there is no interference and all being taking place, and it is transferring the data. And the second one, you can see there is a multi-mode where you have been transferring different information at that same time. That means it is going to carry the multiple beam. When I'm been having this multiple beam, then multi-mode fiber is used for the shorter distance. Because what happens, as there is a lot of distance to travel, the lot of rays that has been traveling, so it is going to collide up. You can check here, there is a collision of the rays been taking place. So this multi-mode fiber is used for the shorter distance. As there is a lot of collision being taking place, once the collision takes place, remember, the signal strength is going to decrease. So that one we cannot afford. So multi-mode fibers are used for a less. Now you can check if you see the people putting the fiber cables on the in the street, they dig it and put it. You can check that there will be a lot of cables within that one. Right, and you can see there will be only one particular cable. They are using the single mode fiber cables. They are not using multi-mode. Multi-mode, whenever they are having, again there will be some station connected to that, so that the information will be transferred. Okay, now these are the connectors Okay, now you can see they are being attached at the end of the cable, and they are being used for the connecting. That means to either connect or disconnect to the port. Now you can check here. You can see that the different types of the connectors. One is the standard connector, okay, and the another one is lucent connector, and the last one is the straight tip connector. So I think these types of the connectors you might have seen, the straight tip connector where you usually connect it to your mobiles and all, right? So a very simple straight tip will be there, not having much of the cables in that one. And you can see here lucent connector for duplex connectors. A transfer of the data is in both the ways, in and out together. And there is a standard connector which is also acting as a duplex connectors. That means data transfer takes place in both the ways, in and out. So these are being used for as a connectors. Moving on to the next one is we are having the internet interconnect devices that we'll see in the next class.